Thank you. Is this on? Fantastic. Hello, everybody. Thank you and welcome to the second concert of our CSU Jazz Ensembles here for spring 2017. That first tune was a Frank Foster composition called Blues in Haas Flat, also known as Blues in Frankie's Flat. It's a nice tune because it's written in D flat, which is a tune or a key that a lot of bebop players don't play, and it's more associated with gut bucket blues style playing, and it's fun to play a big band chart in that key sometimes. We heard, who played on that? We heard from Carla Rogers on trumpet. Carla Rogers. Chris Assertion on tenor saxophone. Michael Rinko on bass. Michael Rinko. Garrett Welch. Garrett Welch on piano. Didn't miss anybody. Fantastic. I love that tune a lot, and I'm not going to talk about it much more, but it's one of the tunes that, like, I keep track of how many times I get to play it in my life, so that on my deathbed I can say I got to play Blues in Haas Flat 127 times. There's a couple of tunes that I do that with, and that's one of them. We're going to play, next we're going to feature our rhythm section on an arrangement that I did many, many years ago on a tune called Up with the Lark. Which is, it's not really a standard, it's a lesser known jazz standard, if you will. It was recorded by Bill Evans, and he reharmonized it to be a little bit more involved in the original version of it. But since it's a Bill Evans tune, I wrote it to feature piano and sort of to feature the trio in general over here, so the horn players have to not be the center of attention for a large section of this chart, which is unusual for big band, and it's something that's fun to do with this. We'll also hear from Brittany Davis on this and Chris Assertion. This is Up with the Lark. Brittany Davis on soprano saxophone. Keep it going for Chris Assertion on tenor. And the rhythm section, Garrett Welch, Mike Rico, Tim Sanchez. Perfect. Let's see here, what's next? All right, we are gonna do another arrangement of mine of a Regina Spektor tune called Someday. One of the things that I like to do is take a pop music that is ripe for exploration and bring it over. It's not my idea. We've been doing that in jazz for 100 years now, but doing pop music that's out from like right now is fun to do sometimes. You may or may not know this tune. Is I consider it pop music, but it's really independent, lesser known music. So anyway, we're gonna feature Alexis on this as well as John Hanlon. This is Some Days.
tune before we take a brief break to change over for the bands and bring out our guest solo for tonight, the great drummer Matt Wilson. The last tune we're going to play is a tune that was written by Chuck Mangione, which you may know from his later days of playing Feels So Good and things like that, which is wonderful music. But Chuck Mangione, when he was younger, was one of the hard bop people and was running in those circles and writing music for that style. And this is a tune that he wrote called Something Different that was arranged by Ernie Wilkins for a big band record done by Cannonball Adderley called African Waltz. And this was the first track that was on that album. It's always one that I think is just outstanding piece of music. I love Ernie Wilkins' writing, and this tune is particularly fun that he arranged. We're going to feature Brittany Davis, and we're going to feature Natalie Jenkins. Who else is blowing on this? We're on the play. Hey, Jimmy. Thank you. Jimmy Ackman is playing this late call. I almost forgot. Cool. So, this tune is Something Different. Thanks so much for listening to our portion of the show. Do stick around for the second half. It's a very, very special collection of music for you to hear.
Two,
CSU Jazz Ensemble tune.
One, two, three. That's Hannah Lentz at the piano. Hannah Lentz. Joe Hofarth on the tenor saxophone. Joe Hofarth. Aidan King on the trombone. Aidan King. And this is Matt Brown on the drums. Matt Brown. Thank you so much for being here. That was a chart written, the tune is written by the great drummer Jeff Hamilton, but it was arranged by the great bassist and band leader John Clayton. And that was a tune called Max. And we are really, really so happy that we have the chance to play with him and you have the chance to hear our special guest tonight. Matt Wilson's been playing with heavy, heavy jazz musicians for decades. Even though he's a farm boy, like myself, go farm boys. But has had the chance to play with Charlotte. I mean, it's just been like talking with Matt over the past couple of days about like playing with Charlie Hayden and Dewey Redman. And after here, he flies straight from, tomorrow he flies from here to Wichita to play with Pat Metheny, which is, he's a pretty good guitar player. And it's just been a real treat. And he's an amazing presence and a fantastic teacher and a great composer, as you're going to hear as well. So we're going to get rolling here with one of his tunes. Please help me welcome Mr. Matt Wilson. Matt Wilson.
Off the top, please.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Let's hear for Joe. He's from, where is he from?
Idaho.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here. It's always great to be in Greeley. Oh, I'm just messing with you. Sorry. They're fighting words. No, Fort Collins, man. Wow. It's my new favorite place. I love it. Visit all the local sites. Put some money back in the economy. So that's good. You can buy some CDs tonight to help, you know, kind of counteract that. It'd be nice. But it's great. And what about this band? Beautiful. And what about the first man, Will Swindler and his ensemble, man. Those guys are rocking. Thank you. Great. So it's great to be here, and it's great to be playing this music, American music, and we appreciate that so much, and the feeling that we are offering and the feeling that we're receiving from you folks. So we appreciate it from the bottom of our heart that you take the time out to share these moments. That was a tune that I wrote called The Scenic Route, which is a title track for one of my records on Palmetto Records. And we're going to continue with something else that I recorded on one of those records too, but I also record on my latest record, which I have a few copies of with me if you'd like to purchase. And this is a tune that I wrote for a jazz festival that's in my hometown of Galesburg, Illinois. Galesburg, Illinois is also the birthplace of the great American poet, Mr. Carl Sandburg. And I have a record coming out in the fall of music that I've written to all his poetry, so keep your eye out for that. But this tune is based on a jazz festival there, and it's going to celebrate its 40th year in a couple of years, and it's a town of 30,000 people. So it's great that if every town in America had a jazz festival of 30,000 people, the world would be a better place, I think. So definitely. So this tune is called 25 Years of Rutabagas, and it's not a diet plan.
Nothing like waking up and juicing up a few rutabagas. A little bit of ginger, a little bit of apple, sets you right up for the day. And but the rutabaga story is this. If you've ever checked them out by Carl Sandburg, are really great. So the festival is named after that. And so this is a tune that I wrote dedicated to my farm roots for all the farmers in August that would come out and do all the dancing then. And it's a jazz country waltz called 25 Years of Rutabaga. So we're going to feature a lot of cats, but we're going to feature out Hannah out on the front playing a little gospel piano for you. So 25 Years of Rutabaga. Ladies' choice on this one for the dance floor.
Matt Wilson on the drums. Matt Wilson. So we're going to play a tune by Will Swindler here. For many years now, when we've had a guest artist, if Will was able to write a piece just for that guest artist, or we found a chart of Will's that he'd maybe written recently that would work. And so this next tune we're going to play of his is from, I think it's from last year or the year before, maybe last year? 2 years ago, it says on the thing. That makes sense, 2 years ago. I'm going to pretend I set that up. It makes sense that it was 2 years ago because this was written for his daughter, Annika. And this chart is called Tantrum in D. And Annika is now 5 years old. And so this was written when she was 3 years old. There's also another chart he wrote called The Real Me, which is like the opposite of the Tantrum in D song about his three-year-old daughter. But this is the one called Tantrum in D. And this is going to feature, let's see, Andrew on the alto, and Joe on the tenor, and Kyle on the flugelhorn, and some just general shenanigans by everybody. So this is Tantrum in D.
Let's hear from Matt Brown coming up.
Yeah, Matt Brown.
So a couple of things. First of all, just to put it in your mind even more, this is what the latest compact disc sound looks like. It looks nice, right? And it sounds really great too. It's a combination of all of my bands, and it's dedicated to the memory of my wife who passed away about 3 years ago. And it's a lot of her favorite tunes, and there's a tune written on there for her and stuff like that. So if you want to buy one, just see me afterwards. I have triplet son. I have a 19-year-old daughter who's in school, and I have triplet sons who turned 16 yesterday. And my life is a tantrum in D. It doesn't change really after 5, and the teenage years. Anyway, it's a monumental day for them. They flew on their own somewhere where they're meeting me in Wichita tomorrow, and they flew on their own. They did great. They got bumped up to first class. Last night, too, I had a little mishap. I was here rehearsing this particular next tune we're going to play, which is My Salute to the Big Band Era, and I took this little tile off the drum that was a muffle, and then I put on a music stand, and I hit the music stand, and I broke it. So I want to give a new tile to Tim Sanchez, and it says Tim's tile, muffle with care. So here. I guess the press isn't here for that, but that's all right. So this is a tune called Nibble, and it's just kind of I grew up playing a lot of big band gigs on the weekend as a kid, and I always loved it, and I still love it, you know, to go out and play for dancers, so this is kind of that, but the beginning is kind of like, woo, people dance to that, they dislocate their hips back where I'm from. So this is called Nibble, and it features the whole band and you too, eventually. So please... welcome to the band.
Tune their brushes, actually. Thank you.
town is such a great food town. Decided to do a little vamp vibration over the 16251 chord progression, stating our favorite foods. But we're going to start out with two Italian favorites. Here we go.
We like pasta.
What else do you cats like? Let us know.
Wiener Schnitzel.
Burrito.
What?
Yeah.
Cheerios.
Catch the CSU Jazz Ensemble live broadcast every Thursday night, bringing you the big band specialties of the day. Under the direction of the great Peter Summers, the Jazz Ensemble will tour a wide range of repertoire, along with the great band led by Will Swinburne, here on the campus of Colorado State University. So, meanwhile, stay attention, stay tuned every Thursday night.
Cats. See it from Matt Brown back there. Downtown Matt Brown. He had more drums than I did. Come on. Stand up there. Matt Brown. Matt Brown, we hung out last time. We had a nice conversation. And he's a fine young man. I expect a lot of things from him in the future. One of the most important jobs he has in the next day or so is to pick me up on time to bring me to the airport. So let's just give Matt a big round of applause and make sure that he gets up on time in the morning and sets his alarm. Let's hear it for this great band one more time. Stand up, cats. Peter Summers and the Cats. So we got one more to do for you. It's by Thad Jones. And we hope you enjoy it. I love you guys. I love Colorado. As always, thank you so much. And thank you for supporting this music. We love you, Colorado State. We love you, Fort Collins.
One more time for Matt Wilson on the drums.